Hi everyone, thanks for joining me today. Let's read the title of our lesson, Unity Without God, Babel. Have you ever wondered why people around the world speak so many different languages? The Bible has the answer. We are going to look at that answer in a moment. But first, we are going to finish the story of Noah and his family. Today's verse is Psalms 31:23. The Lord preserves the faithful, but the proud he pays back in full. The Bible is a book of history. The Bible explains to us why the world is the way it is. It tells us historical facts. The creation is fact. The flood is fact. The story of the flood and Noah's Ark is not just a children's story. It's historical fact, and this history is in the writings of many ancient cultures. Noah trusted in God to save him and his family from the flood, which God said he would send. Genuine faith can only be proved by obedient action. Noah completely believed God's warning that he would destroy the world by flood. So he built an ark according to the direction God gave him. If we truly trust in God, then we will fully obey him. Do you know what Noah and his family did when they first came out of the ark after the flood? Then Noah built an altar to the Lord. Noah took some of all the clean birds and animals, and he burned them on the altar as offerings to God. Genesis 8:20. After God stopped the rain and dried the land, he told Noah and his family to come out of the ark. Then, as usual, Noah came to God with the blood of animals in the way God told him, like Abel did. He worshiped God for saving him and his family. Noah believed God would save him through the coming Savior. Before Jesus Christ, all who believed brought animal sacrifices as an act of faith in God's promise to send a Savior. And God found Noah righteous. God was pleased with the sacrifices and said, "I will never again curse the ground because of human beings. Their thoughts are evil even when they are young, but I will never again destroy every living thing on the earth as I did this time." Genesis 8:21. Noah's true faith and complete obedience touched God's heart. God put the rainbow in the sky as God's sign to show that he would never again destroy the earth by flood. When we truly trust in God and obey him, God is pleased. Many years have passed since God saved Noah and his family from the great flood. God has kept his word. Once again, many people lived on the earth. As time went on, people forgot about God's terrible judgment on the earth by the flood. They had heard about the flood, and they knew that God was their creator, but they ignored God and turned away from what they knew to be the truth about God. Their minds became more evil and foolish. They were like Satan in their thinking. They wanted to be great and important. They were only thinking about themselves. They had great plans for their city and tower, and they said to each other, "Let's build for ourselves a city and a tower, and let's make the top of the tower reach high into the sky. We will become famous. If we do this, we will not be scattered over all the earth." Genesis 11:4. They began to think that if they worked hard together, they could do what they wanted and get what they wanted without God. People were so consumed with themselves that their thoughts were far from God. And it's so sad to know that this is very common in our society these days. People think there is no need to seek God because they think they can live well without God. But the Word of God says, "The Lord preserves the faithful, but the proud he pays back in full. Psalms 31:23. Unity without God fails. Fame and achievement without God are foolish and all fail. The people wanted to reach heaven through the great tower they were working on, but they didn't succeed. We cannot reach heaven by our own efforts either. Only God lets us reach Him by the way He provided us. The rebellious and proud attitude of the people resembles Satan, who rebelled against God in heaven. Apparently, the people were being led by Satan. God was interested in the people, even though they had forgotten Him. God sees all people everywhere. He is our Creator. Can anyone fight against God and win? When Satan was in heaven, he tried to fight against God, but he lost. The people of Noah's time lost in their rebellion against God. What do you think happened this time? Did Satan and the people win? No one can fight against God and be the winner. God is greater than all. Now we will read about how the Lord took control of the situation. God came down to see the city and the tower that the people had built and said, "Come, let us go down and confuse their language. Then they will not be able to understand each other." Genesis 11:7. Do you remember that God said in the beginning, "Let us make man in our image"? Genesis 1:26. Now again, we see God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit discussing what they were about to do. God caused the people to speak different languages. Because men could no longer understand one another, they separated into their various families and moved away to different parts of the country. Finally, they stopped building the tower, and it was called Babel because God confused the language of the whole world. This passage tells us how the different nations, races, and languages we know in the world began. Do you know there are roughly 6,500 languages in the world? There are about 650 ethnic groups in 190 countries. Wow! That's a lot! On the outside, we look different from one another. We have different skin, eyes, and hair. We eat different food and speak different languages. But on the inside, we all have the same problems as the people of Babel did. We do not naturally honor God and obey God. Instead, we want to do things our own way to honor ourselves, just like the people of Babel. We want to be proud of ourselves. We want to be rich. We want to succeed. We are obsessed with ourselves. But what about God? After man sinned against God, immediately, God promised the way to be saved through the seed of the woman. At that time, God commanded Noah to build an ark to preserve Noah and his family. Who is the seed of the woman? Jesus. And what is the ark in the great flood? Jesus. Jesus is the only solid tower that reaches heaven given by God. God keeps telling us about Jesus through the Word. We'll be in big trouble if we miss Jesus. Satan always tries to take us the wrong way and confront God, but nothing can beat God. God never lets the evil go without punishment. He is the Almighty God. Our God is powerful in what He does and what He says. Let's pray. Dear God, we thank You and praise You. We know that because You love us, You sent Your Son Jesus to die for us so our sins can be forgiven. You are almighty and powerful, and we want to obey You in all that we do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'll see you next time. Bye.